Hello and welcome everyone to the War Thunder game. My name is Iron Rifle, and in today's video, well, I did receive a couple of questions from you guys because, well, the recent thing with the Russian with the year 2s on the tier 11 and 12 made some of you quit the game, well, quit the game, discourage you from playing the game because, well, base is destroyed, the base is under attack, and eventually you're losing the game because, well, one guy in the year 2 is screwing everyone up, or, well, one or two or three guys in the year 2s, and they want to quickly win the battle. And a couple of you did ask me about, well, what can you do about it, how can you counter it, is it worth going after it? Well, I would say depending on what you're playing as the nation. If you are playing the US or German on the tier that the, well, the year 2s will be present, so a tier 11, tier 12, I would say go for them. In the German especially, they have very good climb rate, they are, well, climbing like hell, but they do have the means to do some damage. Also the Americans on this tier with the Cobras, King Cobras, they are very, very good at it. From tier 9 to tier 11. P-38G Lightning is also a very, very good aircraft to do so. But with the Americans you do need to start the climb a bit earlier than you would in the, well, any other, with the Germans especially. Also the F4Us, tier 7, tier 8 and tier 12, they are also good, but, well, the tier 7 and 8 Corsairs, well, they only have machine guns, so they will be lacking a bit, but you do have the means to destroy the year 2s and, well, to do some damage to them. But today I was playing the game with my Germans. We did lose this game, but, well, I am not discouraged by it, because, well, I did my job properly. I was flying the Germans, I did spot the year 2s in the beginning of the game, and I did went for them, and then I went, well, just for the high altitude bombers, and I did force them to, well, our base got destroyed to about half, so half of the hit points from the base was taken, but I was the, well, I would say I was the only one going after the high altitude bombers like year 2s, but there were one or two more guys that were helping me, especially when the bombers got into some mid or low tier altitudes. But I did have means to do it, and I did it. The game, I started the game with the Dornier, so that was, well, it's a bit of a change from my usual BF-109E3 in this setup, in this lineup. And I went with it just because, well, the E3 don't have that great of the burst mass compared to the Dornier. So that was the reason I did went with the Dornier. And, well, I must say I did, well, very poorly in it, because, well, I did manage to kill one aircraft with it, one BF-109, and then I went into the head-to-head with the ME-410, and, well, unfortunately, the ME-410 claimed the kill on me. But that was for the Dornier. The next part was in the BF-109 G2 Trop, and this part was, well, was very, very good. I did manage to end up the game with losing only the Dornier and scoring a total of 6 kills. So, well, match or not match, well, I don't know if it is match for you, but, well, 6 kills in total, that's a good score. That's a good score for me. So, guys, without any further ado, let's go. Let's go on. Let's see the video. Let's see the movie. And I got myself into the ground strike in George mission, so I will start off with the, well, Dornier 217N1, so a tier 7 aircraft. Let's gain some more altitude at start, It's always a good idea. And I'm the first to spawn in here. And I don't know what's going on with my FPS, but well, I will have to live with that. So there is first BF-109. Oh, and there are a couple of bombers. Or a couple of ER-2s, so I do need to better get there and try to kill them. Spitfire is going low. There's some ME410s. Going into head-to-head with the Dornier is never a good idea. Okay, there's the ME410. And he got me. I did score a couple of hits into him. But let's take the BF-109 and make sure that the ER-2s don't go and kill everyone, or kill our base. Because that would be most unfortunate. There are the other ER-2s, and they are going way, way high, so... But I do now have the aircraft that will be able to go after them without too much trouble. But the first target will be the B-25 Mitchell. Okay, so that's one enemy down. Now the ER-2s. Okay, this ER-2 is going into the dive, so that won't be my problem. How about you, my friend? Okay, there's the other ER-2, and he's probably going after our base. Okay, you are on fire. Good. He is destroyed. Okay, now another bomber. The TU-2. Okay, another one down. Now they take care of those year twos. Well, year two and P2. I did pick up a lot of speed. So let's try to use it to regain as much altitude as I can. And there goes my wing. Is the landing going after me? No, it disengaged. Okay, cannon's back up, so let's try to do something about this guy. Okay, another year two is down. Suffer the damage to your oil tank. So let's turn and finish you off. Okay, let's assist. The Spitfire took the kill. Okay, how's our base doing? Half of health. So we'll have to go after the P2. Quick check on the scoreboard. Okay, Mr. P2. Your gunner is unconscious. Well, one of your gunners is unconscious. You suffer damage to your rudder. Come on, die already. Okay, no need for me to go that low. And I do hate when the camera does that. So, 5 kills. Let's get some more. Well, I did score a kill. So, any more high altitude bombers? There's the GU. Okay, both of GU-87s. Okay, Yak-1B. I am not in a position to fight you, mate. Yeah, good, we are taking the initiative. Okay, right now I am in position to go after you. And we won the game. Well, it was a very hard to go after the any aircraft without a wing, so I didn't have a full control over my aircraft. But I would say that was a good decision, and well, 27,000 experience and 16,000 credits. Well, the credits could be better. But well, 6 aircraft destroyed, I did lose one aircraft, so that's ain't that bad of a score. And so, that was the battle. Unfortunately, I didn't notice that before, but well, we did suffer a defeat in this mission. I was thinking that we won it, but well, it is very early in the morning when I'm recording it, so I would say I was a bit sleepy. And I didn't pay enough of the attention to the scoreboard. But well, the game was lost, but I do feel like I did my part in it. And well, guys, that's the thing. If you are flying Germans, if you are flying the US, go for high altitude bombers if you see them. Don't go for the easy kills, don't go for the easy prey, and well, fight in the lower altitude, like the, well, lower-ish altitude, like the British Spitfires and the, well, Russians too, because, well, they are a bit in the middle here, in the middle of the high altitude and, well, low altitude fighting. They are good dogfighters, though. So, don't go with them if you are, well, you can go with the British, with the Russians, and with the Japanese against any high altitude bomber, but it will be more difficult for you. If you are flying the Germans, you definitely should be going after high altitude bombers and trying to score some kills against them. So guys, that would be it. Because, well, I did answer your question, I did show you the mission in which I did prevent the enemy from destroying our base. Unfortunately, I could not prevent them from, winning the game in the end. But, well, it doesn't really matter. I did my part, and as long as you are doing your part, and as long as you are, well, performing and doing everything as you should be doing, that's only a minor inconvenience that you will be losing, because well, you will get a good scores, you will be paid for your good scores, and well, as the War Thunder is working right now, you do get a slight bonus for winning the game, but it's not that major. You are paid out for what you are doing in the air. So guys, to wrap up the video, there will be one more video this week coming up. Well, it will probably be during the weekend. I will try to record it tomorrow, and it will be posted during the weekend. Also, you can try to visit me on Twitch again. I am streaming like hell every day. Usually Monday to Friday, and in the mornings I do usually play some other games, and in the evenings I do usually play War Thunder. So that would be for the Twitch, if I do remember everything correctly, that would be it. I do think that this would be it. So guys, again, like the video if you like it, subscribe, remember about subscribing to my channel, it will help me greatly. Also, yeah, well, that also. That would be it. That would be it, Iron, what you're talking about. So guys, again, thanks for watching, thanks for tuning in, and I do hope to see you all next time, but until then, Iron Rifle out.